Sir, my name is Kumar Swami Hariharan. My question is to Zaheer Naik, sir. One of my friend purchased the Quran and came to my room. I was so interested and just I went to have a look of it. Immediately he told me that this is the holy book, since it has been written by the God directly. You should not touch till that date. Whenever I am moving to his house, till now I am not touching it. Is it the right or wrong? I don't know. Since he is following correctly. And one more question, sir. And another friend, this time he is moving to his house for celebrating the Ramzan. He told, "Hello Hariharan, I am moving." So by hearty love I went to hug him. Then immediately he told, "No, no, you should not hug." Then I asked him whether today is the day we should not hug. I don't know about it. That's why I asked, "Today is the day we should not hug." Then he told, "No, you should not hug at all to a Muslim." This is the another friend I asked. Then he told, "No, it's wrong answer. You can hug." From that time, whenever I am hugging, I feel myself guilty and shy. I am doing the wrong thing. Please clarify my doubts, sir.
Brother has asked two very important questions, two great misconceptions. The first question of his was that one of his friends said when he went to touch the Quran, "No, you cannot touch the Quran. This is the word of Almighty God." Is it true that non-Muslims can't touch the Quran? There is a misconception, as this conference is not only for the non-Muslims, as it was said, it's even for the Muslims. There's a misconception amongst the Muslims that a non-Muslims cannot touch the Quran. And this misconception is based on one verse of the Quran, of Surah Waqia, chapter number 56, verse number 77-80, which says that this Quran has been revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and none shall touch except those who are pure. Now, based on this verse of the Quran, many non-Muslims, they assume that the Muslims are pure, non-Muslims are impure, they cannot touch it. This, you should know, the Nuzul-e-Quran, when was this verse revealed? This verse of the Quran was revealed when many non-Muslims objected and said that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam knows billah, he gets this revelation from the Satans. So then this verse was revealed that none shall touch except those who are pure, talking about the Quran of Lauhe Mehfooz. If you read Tafsir ibn Kathir, it gives the clarification that this is talking about Lauhe Mehfooz, the Quran which is there in the seventh heaven, none shall touch except the angels. The Arabic word there, mutahharin, mentioned refers to the angels, not only pure in body, but those who are sinless. So that Quran which is in Lauhe Mehfooz, none shall touch except the angels. So if a Satan wants to pick up these parts of the Quran, he cannot come close to it. It doesn't refer to mere tahara, which we talk about wudu. If this verse really means none shall touch except those in wudu, any non-Muslim can purchase a Quran for 150 rupees and touch it, and the Quran will be proved wrong. So this verse doesn't talk about the wudu. It talks about the Lauhe Mehfooz, which none shall touch, no human being can also touch, except the angels. And I always encourage that the best book you can give, the best message, is the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My speech is useless. What human being can explain better than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, creator? We have to share the message of the Quran. And there are some people who say, "Brother Zakir, okay, fine, give only the translation, not the Arabic." I said, "Fine, okay, that also, you want to give, give at least." But I prefer giving along with the Arabic. Why? Because in the translation, they can make a mistake. If the mistake is there, it can be attributed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrongly and falsely. For example, some of the Urdu translations say of Surah Luqman, chapter 31, verse 34, that no one besides Allah knows what is the sex of the child in the mother's womb. If a non-Muslim who has medical knowledge, today with ultrasonography, we can easily come to know what is the sex of the child. I, being a doctor, I know that. The translation is wrong. Nowhere does Allah use the word sex. What Allah says, no one will know what is in the womb of the mother, talking about the nature of the child, whether the child will be good or bad, whether it will be bane for society or boon for society, whether it will go to Jannah or Jahannam, hell or paradise. No one knows. All the scientists with the best equipment, they cannot predict this. So the translation is a mistake. So if we give the Arabic text, anyone who knows Arabic can testify that the translator has made a mistake, not Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I personally prefer giving along with the Arabic text. And if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala holds me responsible, I'll be in good company. You know why? Because the beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he, when he gave the message to the non-Muslim kings, he dictated ayahs of the Quran to the Sahabas. And one of such of the letters is already present in Koptaki Museum in Turkey. And there Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he had dictated the verse of the Quran of Surah Al-Imran, chapter number 3, verse number 64, which says, Kul, Ya Ahl al-Kitab, say, O people of the book, Ta'alaw ila kalmatin sawa'in bayna baynakum, come to common terms as in us and you. Which is the first term? Allah, na'udha illallah. That we worship none but Allah. Wala nushrika bihi shayyan. That we associate the partners with him. Wala yattakhiz abadun abadan arbaban min dunillah. That we erect not among ourselves lords and patrons other than Allah. Fa'intawallaw. If then they turn back. Fakullu shadu. Say, bear witness. Bi anna muslimun. That we are Muslims bowing our will to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam dictated letters containing verses of the Quran which were given to non-Muslims. Many non-Muslims, you know, some of them accepted Islam, alhamdulillah. Some tore the letter. Some even trampled it beneath their feet. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave verses of the Quran to a non-Muslim. He tramples it beneath his feet. So, brother, there's no problem at all. You being a non-Muslim, you can read the Quran. We Muslims, we sit like cobras on the Quran. It is not our property. It is everyone's property. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is revealed. You can very well read the translation.
Thank you.
Read the translation. If you think something is worth accepting, accept it. If you have any queries, you can ask the person who has knowledge on the Quran. You can touch it. There's no problem at all. If anyone says that, why can't Muslim touch? You ask him for proof. There's no verse in the Quran or no hadith which says that you cannot touch. Now coming to your second question. That can a non-Muslim embrace a Muslim? Or can a Muslim embrace a non-Muslim? Brother, alhamdulillah, there's no problem at all. Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he embraced many non-Muslims. Our sahabas, irrespective whether black or white, rich or poor, yellow or brown, king or pauper, there's no problem, alhamdulillah. This is good. It shows universal brotherhood. There's no problem at all, brother. Embracing, you can very well embrace. A Muslim can embrace a non-Muslim. A non-Muslim can embrace a Muslim. There's no verse in the Quran hadith which says that Muslim and non-Muslim can't embrace. This is a misconception. Your Muslim friend, he does not have proper knowledge of Islam. That's why he might have told you out of ignorance. But in Islam, you can very well embrace. There's no problem.
Thank you very much, sir.
Brother Hariharan, please come to the stage. Dr. Zakir Naik will present him a translation of the Quran.
Here we can say that Zakir Naik himself has given me a translation of the Quran.